Hi guys, this is Arkel here, and for those of you who watch me on DeviantArt, you will already know what this video is about, but for those of you who don't, this is my second channel, and on my second channel I figured that I would go ahead and do some fun little random videos, and one of which being art supply hauls. Yes! So anyway, I did tell you guys that I would be doing a haul video once some of my art supplies came in from various places here, so I'll go ahead and show you what I got. Alright, so I'm going to show you the stuff that I got, and the first place that I made an order from was one of my favorite stores called Art Supply Warehouse. And I've actually been to the store, they actually have a storefront, and they're here in California. They're not too far away, but I did move, so I usually just order from them online now. And so I'll go over the stuff that I got from there first. They carry like tons of art supplies, even carry like Copic markers and all that kind of stuff. So they are awesome. Anyway, so this is something that I've wanted for a really long time. These are watercolor inks. They're like liquid, really highly concentrated watercolors. So let me just go ahead and open this. I'm not going to spend too much time on each individual thing so I can show you guys everything. But these are just like little glass vials, and they have these like really highly concentrated like watercolor ink, and it's just ink, so you can use it like with an inkwell pen and stuff like that too, or you can use a brush and whatever, and they're just really, really bright, and I've been meaning to get some of these because watercolors, in my opinion, can often be very, they can get muddy very fast, and they can not be as bright and saturated as I would like. So I want to go ahead and try some of these, and these are just gorgeous. Ha! Alright, so my next little thing that I got is stuff for my Copic multiliners, and I got some extra multiliners too. As you guys know, I use my, here it is right here, my Copic SP multiliner in Sepia. And this is, I know it says right here, you can see that it says 0.3. You can see that. But I actually use 0.03 nibs, and you can see here 0.03. Now, see, I don't know if it's just me, I can't seem to find an SP pen that actually comes with a 0.03 nib in it. The smallest I can tend to find is 0.3. So what I end up doing is I just basically, you can see that I have these colored nibs in here, and basically I just took the nib out of the pen that it came with and replaced it with a really tiny one. You can't really see that. But I replaced it with my usual size nib, which is 0.03, like I said. So I got some extras of those. I always get extras of these because I go through nibs like crazy, because they just sort of wear down pretty fast, and that can affect your line work if you're not careful. So I got some extras of those. Of course, I replaced these two over here, and I'll get to those in a second. I got some more sepia pens. These are just disposable kind because I don't really use thicker pens very much. I don't feel like spending a bunch of money on SP pens. But you can see, oh, that's kind of glare-ish. Glare-ish. A little, I speak good English. anyway, you can see that these are a bit varied sizes. There's 0.05, there's 0.1, 0.3, and 0.5. And I just kind of wanted some bigger pens, because although my line art is really thin, there are some areas that I would like to get a little bit thicker, and it's hard to do that with such a tiny pen. So I got some of those. 0.05 is also a really good size too, if you think that 0.03 is too small. And then of course I got some a refill for my Copic SP, the Sepia, this one, because you know you don't really go through ink very fast in these. But whenever I make an order to Art Supply Warehouse, I tend to go ahead and grab nibs and replacement cartridges just in case. And then I got some more SP liners. And these are in, whoops, shaking my camera. These are in red and turquoise. So you can see those here on the little
bottoms here. I always look for really light colors when I'm looking for line art pens. I don't tend to, of course, as you guys probably know, I don't use black. Very rarely, anyway, do I use black. So I like really light colors, and I kind of wanted to experiment more with a few other different colors, because sepia is really good for, like, outlines on faces and skin and hands and all that good stuff. But it's not always so great for, like, hair and whatnot. If the hair is like a really light color, or it just doesn't really go with it that well. I mean, it doesn't look bad, but I mean, you know, I just like to, I'm trying to experiment and see how these work out. So, yes, red and turquoise. I thought these would look really great, and they're light colors, so thumbs up. All right. And this is another thing that I've wanted for, like, forever. I've wanted to play around with this stuff. This is polymer clay, specifically Fimo Soft. And I've always wanted to do sculpting. Like, oh my gosh, I've always wanted to try that. It's, like, one of my things, like, artistic medias that I've always wanted to try. And polymer clay looks, like, so much fun. People make the cutest little figures and, like, little charms and whatnot out of it. So I've wanted to try this for a long time. And I saw they had this, like, little mini, like, trial set with all these different colors. And I thought it'd be fun to sort of play around with it and just, you know, sort of nonsensical modeling here. And so it comes with all these different little colors. Here, I'll show you. I've already actually gotten into one of these because I wanted to play with it. I'm sorry, I had to. But I got into this one. I don't know if you can tell. I'm kind of good at making it look like I didn't. But anyway, so it has these tiny little blocks. And they're really not that big. Like you can see, they're not that big at all. But I don't know, maybe just me, but when I try out new medias, I tend to not get that much of them to start with, just to see if I like it. Because if I don't like it, then I don't want to have spent all that money on something that I won't use. So I tend to get smaller things like that. Also, I happened to also grab some translucent. This is translucent white. I don't know if you can... No, you can't see that. My camera sucks. Anyways, this is just some translucent white. And I want to get some of this too because it seems to give, like, when you make figures and whatever, it seems to give the figures a bit more depth and a bit more realism and not so plasticky looking when you mix it in there, from what I've seen. So I thought I would go ahead and grab some of that too and see how that looks. So we'll see what polymer clay creations I make. Alright, so I have a few other little things here. These are just sort of random little odds and ends that just sort of don't really go together, so I figure I just put these all together. They're just some little random things I'm meaning to get also. These are just like standard little like cotton gloves. When you're using like things like pastels and whatnot, it's a really good idea to wear cotton gloves. Just because the oils in your fingers, they can sort of mess up your pastels. So it's always a good idea to have these, and these are super cheap. I've never bothered to get them, but I decided that, like, yeah, I kind of need them, so I went ahead and grabbed some of those. So I like wearing gloves, by the way. I just think they're nice. Anyway, this, I don't know, I got like a random little like present, I guess, like a little free gift. And these are like little acrylic tubes, like Liquitex acrylic paint. I don't really like paint with acrylic that much, but I have used it before. And these are like a nice color. It's like a nice like deep red, and the other one's like an olivey green. And that was just like a cute little like free gift. Get in there. Get in there. All right, whatever. Anyway, that was just like a cute little like free gift, I guess. So that's nice. Of course, and I needed some more Copic paper. I really like this brand of Copic paper, even though the art on the front is kind of misleading, no offense to the artists, but yeah, it's kind of misleading, honestly. But it's really, really good paper. It's really like, I don't know if you can, no, you can't see that. Where is the light? There we go. Anyway, I don't know if you, I guess you can't really tell. It has like a sort of plasticky texture to it, and I really like that for Copic markers. I don't really care for like cardstock and stuff, because I feel like it sort of just soaks up the ink, and I don't know, I just like this better. I think it's easier to move the color around, because it's a little bit plasticky. So there's that. I always need more of this, because I tend to ink my drawings on regular paper, the paper that I've drawn them on, and then I scan them in to my computer and sort of edit them a little bit in Photoshop, and then I go ahead and reprint them out on Copic paper. But it's kind of difficult because I'm not always sure about the how the colors will turn out on the paper, if they'll be too dark or if the lines will be too thick and whatnot. So I end up sometimes using a few more sheets of paper than I'd like to. So I end up having to get more of this because I used more than I'd like to for one of my other Copic drawings. Cry forever. Anyway, there's that. Get this out of the way. Put it over there. And this is some brush cleaner, but I actually don't intend on using this necessarily for brush cleaning, and I'll actually get to that in a second. This is not directly like my drawing art, sort of art related something or other, but I will show you what I'm talking about here in a second.